box office attraction.
Dawson's getting bigger and bigger, and I'm really pleased to be part of it.
Michael Van Gerwen is the Premier League champion. He is still the main man on Planet Darts.
All right, man. I'm sorry.
It's magnificent MVG who masters the Premier League for the sixth time.
We love that emotion, MVG. He is the number one. He's the premier player in world darts.
Michael Vatti, this is exceptional. Van Gerwen is on the rampage. And when he plays like this, it's hard to envisage him ever getting beat. He can win it any way he likes.
Brought to you by the Professional Dance Corporation. Time to meet the Briars. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the UK Open and US Darts Masters. He's a former Premier League finalist and the reigning world match play champion, the Arse Nathan
second half of the Premier League season for the reigning champ, hasn't it? Just one match win in the last 6 weeks. He lost at this stage in Manchester. It was to Luke Littler then. Well, Nathan Aspinall has kind of done the opposite in the last 7 weeks. Well, he's lost only his opening match just the one time. So a really intriguing matchup, this one, and one that could have big ramifications on the top four race and ultimately, well, who ends up in it and who ends up out of it. To guide you through it then, I'll hand you over to Wayne Mardell and Rod Studd.
Thank you, Emmy. Yes, big game this. The big games keep on coming in the Premier League. Fourth versus third at start of play. And players that can ill afford to lose in the quarterfinals, as they would lose ground to other players, including the bully boy Michael Smith. I think everybody thinks Humphries and Littler are going to qualify for the final four at the O2, but mind you, a few weeks ago everyone thought Van Gogh would qualify, so who knows what will happen in the last 6 weeks of the competition. What a night this has been, and what an evening, because it's the second time tonight we have the pleasure of the company of the former almost world darts champion, Wayne Mardell.
Mardell.
Good evening to you again, Hawaii.
Evening, great introduction, thank you. Almost. Nathan Aspinall, a man who's finding a way to win matches against Michael Van Gerwen, a man who's finding a way to lose them at the moment. Like Emma said, his form is not good. He's just won one match in the last 6 weeks. That's Michael Van Gerwen we're talking about. That's how difficult the Premier League is.
He hasn't quite gone from first to worst, but he really has dropped off. And you talk about strange sporting curses. These players that have won a hat-trick of weekly nights on the trot have really struggled since. Humphries, he won in week 6, 7 and 8, then lost a week 9 first match to Littler. Lost his next two, in fact. Managed to get back on the winning track tonight. Van Gerwen does not leave the ball. Won in weeks 2, 3 and 4, then lost to Humphries in week 5. And he's won one of the next 6 games in the Premier League. It really has dropped off.
But it's just impossible to envisage any of those drop-offs literally, Rod, for any of these players, because they are so good.
Well, but maybe it's due to some dark, macabre force as Van Gerwen misses tops. And again,
there was a bit of a lunge with the last one, so that's not surprising that it missed. Nathan Aspinall takes a deep breath, aims at the 57 and misses, so MVG, who has the darts in his first leg, meaning he will have the darts in the last if it goes that far. One and up.
And he'll be grateful of that, because Aspinall has been the master of brinkmanship in the Premier League. He keeps enjoying 6-5 successes, Nathan Aspinall. And he had a couple of 6-5s over Van Gerwen last year. I think he's had 5 this year in the Premier League, 6-5. And he had 2 over Van Gerwen in the 23 Premier League. So MVG will not like it if it goes all the way to an 11th leg as Aspinall re-grips.
It's a great trait to have, isn't it? Winning tight matches. Because your opponent knows that if it does go the whole hog, that your opponent's not going to buckle.
Oh dear.
66.
Salvages it. Well, after a fashion. But how can it be that a man like Michael Van Gerwen can go from throwing like a dream to throwing like a drain?
95.
I know I've said it many times. The players and humans, they're not robots. But I think
96.
It's the differing levels, Rod. The good and the bad. It's never been this way for Michael. The good and the bad were, to be honest, the bad used to win. Now it's getting annihilated because the others, yes, they've got better. When Michael Van Gerwen was off the boil, he could still win matches, but at the moment it's not happening for him.
Yeah, we saw at the World Championship, didn't we? He was playing so well. He was the favourite going on into the quarterfinals and then inexplicably capitulated against Scotty Williams.
Yeah, I don't think even Michael saw anything like that happening. Like I said, the good and the bad, the difference is just, it's a chasm. Double 10!
130!
Be an important passage of play when we come back to look at the final analysis, because the Asp here is looking at a two dart combo to level up, and Van Gerwen could have been 2-0 in front. He wants double 16, Nath. Lovely finish. One each.
MVG has the best of the head-to-head. But I've got to say, I personally feel that that's out of the window right now, because
it was a different head that was playing.
Correct. Michael Van Gerwen is not the same player as he was just a few months ago. When I say the same player, not playing to the same level, as he cracks in his first of this match. And Nathan Aspinall, like I said, he's finding a way to win matches.
You're not suggesting Van Gerwen had been kidnapped and they were seeing an imposter up on the stage, are you?
No, not quite.
No.
Oh, 171 he was looking for there.
133.
Nice second prize. And he will be back for the combination finish of just 54. To regain the lead, and it'll be three legs going with it. Oh, that is loose tops.
14.
It doesn't appear to matter, but...
Well, no, it doesn't appear to matter, but Michael, being a professional darts player, has missed the single number, and you don't like doing that. And then you come back, and all of a sudden, there's darting drama that is now ended. So that will please him that it didn't go to the last dart.
But it's unnecessary angst, isn't it?
Yes. And it takes its toll, especially if it's leg after leg and game after game and when you're not winning.
Well, we've mentioned that since the three-peat in week 2, 3 and 4, Van Gerwen has played 7 matches and won 1. And in the same time frame, Nathan Aspinall has played 14 matches, won 9 and lost 5.
Yeah.
So Aspinall has played better over that sequence of weeks than Van Gerwen. Way better.
Oh, and that was unlucky. Another treble would have left, 1-4-4. And as we know, that's the pros fav for the 9, 60-60-24. Just go through it, Nathan. Just pretend it was in. Yeah, Nathan, there's no doubt about it, Rod. He's been better than Michael Van Gerwen for the last 5 or 6 weeks.
Yes.
4 finals in 7 weeks for Nathan.
Runner up in weeks 4, 7 and 9. 1 in week 5 in Exeter.
36.
And that's all of having lost his first 3 quarter finals. So he was in strife early in the comp.
Yeah.
He now wants 52 again. We've seen this. Oh, now he's at it. He leaves double 16, but one dart instead of 2 at the double.
36.
And again, it doesn't seem to matter.
No.
Because his opponent is so far adrift.
95.
Nathan,
you require 16.
For a 13 dart leg, and to end the faffing. Was this beginning of the faffing? We don't know. Oh dear. No, zero faffage. 2-2. I think a lot of people, Rod, still see Michael Van Gerwen as a young man in his prime of his darting life. He's effectively had a real long career already. He was world number one in the BDO at 17. He was a favourite to win a world title at 17. He was hitting 9 darts against Barney and the like at the age of 17. That was literally, was it 18 years ago now?
Yeah, and your point is well made, Wayne, because even if you talk about his career as being when he was rejuvenated and revitalised and reborn, if you will, in 2012, that's still a dozen years ago, nearly.
Yes, 57.
That's still a long time.
Yes.
To be at the top in a professional sport.
At the top.
And under the pressure of playing in a professional sport for that length of time. It's not easy.
No.
96.
And I still do wonder, will we go to the 0-2 and be thinking of Van Gerwen not playing well this time? They're in a win it, and we'll think, what was all the fuss all about?
Yeah.
A bit like last year, really.
Yeah.
Oh, what is the fuss about? I'll tell you what the fuss is about. It's about the 171 to leave double 18. And he might need to have done that to hold throw, because Aspinall here has got a chance to nudge in front.
20. Bullseye. Oh! What a dart shot!
Have a look at the bullseye here. He enjoyed that, and he knows the significance of that, and he knows it.
I think Nathan is,
and that man behind him knows it too.
It's an enjoyable watch, Nathan. He gives everything. There's, and he's starting off legs very, very well.
140.
His opponent under pressure from the get-go. And a lot of legs here. But what a ball.
Was that the key moment in the match?
82.
Time will tell. It certainly put Aspel in front with the break, but he's still going to ride it out from 3-2 up.
48.
Michael Smith winning has done Michael van Gerwen no favours in terms of points in the league. And if Nathan can carry on playing like this and get this wrapped up, it will be a dismal night for MVG, the seven-time champ.
Well, then he will be under the cosh in terms of qualification, won't he?
And let's get it right. We're on the homeward stretch.
6 weeks left, including this one. And next week, Van Gerwen will be in his native Netherlands.
Playing Luke Humphries. Wow.
It is Rotherham, Wayne, isn't it? Not Rotherham.
Not Rotherham, yeah.
Sorry, we've been doing that joke for a decade now, haven't we?
Long story. Yes.
Haven't got time for it here, thank goodness. Aspinall on tops. Double 10. Van Gerwen waits. Van Gerwen to swoop. He'll step in here. Look at the speed at which he approaches the hockey.
Turning point. Turning point coming up right here. Bullseye. Not to be for MVG. For 4-2. Above or attack?
Attack the double man. Attack it. Well, it's 4-2. And I just wonder, is that tiny target in the middle of the board going to decide this darts match?
55.
Aspinall hit it to lead 3-2. Van Gerwen missed it at the back of that 1-2-2 to level up. Is that the key target in this match?
Nathan started a few legs really well. If he starts this leg with a 140, MVG is in trouble.
83.
Lost the line, unusually for Nathan in general. Not happy. 6 trebleless darts when he could ill afford to hardly miss anything at this point in the game.
100.
He is bang under it now.
Oh, 133.
Well, clearly Van Gerwen can win this match if he loses this leg, but it's highly unlikely that he'll do so. So this.
Yeah, he'd rather
crucial
not lose
leg.
The leg, yeah. Of course.
5-2, it seems a long way back from there. 4-3, it looks game on.
With someone playing slightly better than you as well.
Well,
the last 6 darts have been superb from MVG. Turn this leg around. Nathan really wants to hunt down a treble 20 here. Choosing to go elsewhere.
45. Michael Levan.
No value in that.
That leaves double 19.
80. Nathan, you
would have been the highest finish of the match, the first 3-figure outshot of the match. And Aspinall here has a long range finish of his own. So Van Gerwen coming back for 38. The swashbuckling, swaggering Van Gerwen of old would have gone straight for this, no question. And so does the current incarnation. Double 16, double 8. What a finish. Talk about unorthodox.
It just feels like to me there's darting drama around every corner for Michael. Nothing is just wrapped up. Nothing's done in. You know, we were chatting about Luke Littler earlier about getting it done and dusted quickly and turning games round. Just feels that that's not happening with Michael. With Michael Smith, it kind of happened against Gedwin Price, and Luke Humphries turned it round quick. Michael's just going through the ringer at the moment.
In days of yore, he used to cut you apart like some kind of darting Zorro, didn't
ridiculous,
he?
Ridiculous, yeah. Some of the best darts we've ever seen anyone throw.
And now you feel the epee is blunted. It's 4-3 Aspen, he's got the darts in this leg, but Van Gerwen all over him like a rash.
Yeah.
87.
It was a iffy hold of throw, but this is a magnificent opportunity to break.
117.
I'm not sure if that deflected or it was just a poorly thrown dart.
We saw 171 to leave 36 before, didn't we? He was trying to leave 16 this time. That leaves 80 to make it very interesting at the back end of the eighth.
Happy accident. Massive happy accident there. That goes in the four. Then the bullseye may have come into play, but that treble four meant single to double. And he went pop, pop. And look at Nathan's response. He knows the first dart was so poor, should have been nowhere near that.
Well, we saw the absolutely ludicrous finish at the back end of the last leg, double three, single 16, double eight for 38. That's the way you always go, Wayne.
Yep.
And then that almost calamitous effort from Van Gerwen, but he got out of jail.
Yep. 97. It's a great dart at tops.
And it all adds up to four apiece, and Van Gerwen with the darts.
And Nathan on the rampage.
Yeah, Nathan Aspinall must be wondering what on earth is happening here.
Yeah.
He feels he had his man beaten, saw his man make mistakes, but somehow the mistakes turned into leg wins for Van Gerwen. Bizarre.
Yeah.
58.
Extraordinary scenes here in Birmingham.
When players are on 38, we normally see them go 6.32, but 99. Not double three for the six. So it was slightly unconventional. Even at this point, Rod, it's hard to pick a winner. It really is.
Yeah, ordinarily you'd say the guy throwing first in two of these three legs would be a strong favourite, but I'm not sure you can say that the way Van Gerwen's been throwing this night and in recent nights.
And both these will feel that way. Well, Nathan will most definitely feel that way. He was looking for 171 to leave tops there.
95.
That would have been a hell of a layup.
Well, if this goes, it's not the match, but it would feel like it. It would feel like it. Got the two trebles. Double 16. It's absolutely imperious. It's MVG circa 2017, and he leads now 5-4.
4-2 down, 5-4 up, 1-5-2, pop, pop, pop. And by the way, he's not playing very well. And I'm not saying that being sarcastic, Rodri. He's not playing anywhere near the MVG we've seen over the last decade and a bit. And yet he finds something from somewhere. Wow. The innate ability that he's got.
The last couple of legs at the back end of them, we saw a catalogue of comedy. But Van Gerwen very quickly went from the ridiculous to the absolutely sublime.
And Nathan, on the other hand, has just buckled a little. This is all about MVG. Six darts and it's done.
What depths has he dredged this from?
140.
He looked in trouble. He was in trouble. He was in trouble.
Didn't just look it.
He was in trouble.
100.
4-2 behind. Apparently making a mess of a regulation lollipop finish, but he managed to get hold of it, get that leg one, won the next one as well. And then we just saw the wonderful 1-5-2.
Surprising way for the 1-2-2, in my opinion. He's left tops, but is he going to get a poke? The answer is yes. Michael Van Gerwen to set up a semi-final spot with Michael Smith.
From the brink of defeat, it seemed, to victory for Van Gerwen. Michael Van Gerwen celebrates as well he might. He was 4-2 down in that match, and he runs off four legs straight to defeat Nathan Aspinall and reignite his Premier League campaign and surge into the semi-finals.